Bonjour, mein Soccer-Universe. Welcome to part one of the Ligue 1 jersey review. And honestly, it is an honor to, and it doesn't happen very often, that I can start my jersey review with the jersey of last year's champion, which is Lille in this case. Very, very, very happy to have that shirt even after became champions. That was one of those that I saw a really, really, really need that one. In any case, we will do this, like all the other leagues, we'll do this in four parts, which means since the Ligue 1 is a 20-team league, we have five teams per league, which means I'll be talking a whole lot of time about many jerseys. In part one, we have already, I have a total of 15 jerseys that I want to rate and look at. I got most of them off Footy Headlines, so that was my source. And now, how did I decide which jerseys come in there? I do it like every year. I take last season standings and I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1, and so on, as you see on the side. And everywhere where there's a 1, those teams are in this video. And then I do it somewhat alphabetically. And so we'll start with in the far west. First, almost first west that we can go in France, in Brest, who I think is now their second, if not a third season in a row that they're up there. And what I like about Brest is this your almost quintessential Ligue 1 jersey for a lower team. You take the template of the supplier, which is Puma, Adidas or Nike, and then have a main sponsor and a loads of other sponsors up there, and smash a crest on there. However, I have to say, for some reason, it doesn't look all that bad for Brest, especially this is a silicone crest, which is nicely applied. Yes, there are too many sponsors, and yes, the jersey is not super, super, super exciting. But then on the other side, I think as far as a Brest jersey go, there is not much more that can go wrong. I still would only give this a 5-star rating because, yeah, there's no, yeah, but there is not much to it. But you know, there's also not much wrong. There's no sponsor that's actually really sticking out, being in any way bad. I do, however, like, as always, the other two jerseys for Brest are always like a whole lot more, and it's mainly down to the great sponsor. There's a castle on there. This makes this sponsor look instantly better. I don't know why. It is just looks great. And now this one here in black uses also kind of an adventurous Adidas template that I think we saw last season with Cagliari, and I want to say even Union Berlin. So kind of some stripes, but some paintbrush effect over. And it is in black with white and then a little bit of gray on there. And I honestly think I should have researched it probably, but I think there is some pirate theme to it because there are two crossed sabers below the crest, which we do not see on the other shirts. That sounds looks pretty awesome. There's a castle on there, there are sabers on there, then the middle sponsor is of course, yes, it's a cola brand, but Breji is for the Bretagne, so that is for me pretty cool. That there are two more sponsors up there, yeah, okay, we gotta live with it. I have to say, I like this one a whole lot, and I would even go as far as to give this 7 stars, and that's for a blackout jersey. And then the third jersey is in white with a red sponsor, and I have to say, this one also looks better than the home jersey. And again, down to the sponsor, but look at how this sponsored, there is even some shading effect on there. Yes, it's just a yogurt, but it looks awesome. Absolutely looks awesome. Doesn't look as awesome as the third shirt though, but I have to say, if I wanted to get a Brest shirt, I probably would want to go for this one because I like how the crest pops and then you have the castle on there. If the home jersey had a castle, I probably would go for that. But if one thing, I always say Ligue 1 jerseys is underrated and there are many varieties on there, but if there's one common theme, most of the smaller teams usually have, there's a lot of red home jerseys, let's put it that way. So that's why I think the white one looks a little bit better, but you know, it doesn't delineate itself too much. I would say it's between the two previous ones, and I would give this one 6 stars. And then we go to the defending champions, Lil, for their latest opening by New Balance. And first off, New Balance always produces really weird looking pictures for their jerseys. Just the cut doesn't look right. It looks boxy and bulky. And when you wear their jerseys, yes, you see the cut is weird, but it actually looks kind of normal. I have to say, after the last 2 or 3 seasons where there was a lot of blue on the little jersey, and that's why I actually like this one a whole lot. I'm not sure how little fans feel about it. And I know that before they won the championship in it. This one kind of seems like a step down. And what I also find a step down is that the New Balance logo and the sponsor are now silver, which with the white crest, yes, it pulls the eye towards the crest, but I'm not quite sure that this was the best. It looks a little bit disbalanced, more towards the crest. Then also the collar kind of looks weird with just being on the front. Not a big fan of that. I also have to say the pattern, I hope it is somewhat inspired by the city of Lille. I have my doubts that it is. It gives it some interesting structure. You have a two-tone red look in there. But if I'm perfectly honest, that jersey leaves me rather cold. And I know that in league play there will be a lot more sponsors on there as well. So I'm also going to give this just the 5 stars that I gave the Brest home shirt. I think that the Lille away jersey is even more egregious for the simple reason that, yes, I love the gold on there. We are celebrating the championship. But then there's not much more to it. And to make matters even worse, the sponsor is in orange. At least give me a red here as a club's color, but orange just, it's a really, really sore spot. The jersey otherwise looks rather, I think, take the sponsor out, and I think this is a classy jersey. It makes sense that there's gold on there, but it's not much more. With the sponsor, I honestly have to give this 3 stars. I would have probably, otherwise it would be between 4 and 5. Well, while editing, I saw I forgot one, the little third shirt. And to be honest, while I have been rather tough on the previous two, I have to say this third shirt is pretty cool. Yes, it is black and we have and everything is again silvery white on there, but the crest is red, which, it's maybe not the greatest look because the eye is drawn to the sponsors and the supplier and rather away from the crest. The eyes look for contrast, and red and black is not as big of a contrast as white and black or silver and black. However, what I really like about this one is there is a pattern and it seems to be a fortress. Now, my local knowledge of Lille is rather minimal because I have never been to that city, so I cannot say much. But this looks like a fortress from the city, and that is actually a pretty nice pattern. Now, I do wish that it was accented a little bit with some other colors from the clubs. You know, we have some red that could put a few specks in there that might have been nice, but you know, as a faithful recreation, I actually really like this, and so this is definitely the best Lille jersey this season, and I want to give this 7 stars. We haven't been in the Bretagne for a while. Yes, we go out west again, but now south side of to Lorient. Kappa, I remember last season they had interesting offerings where they had a lot of orange with black. Now it's more the orange with just black as an accent there. And then I think also the Kappa logos and a little bit of the crest is kind of this silver in there. Well, I do have to say, yes, there's a sleeve sponsor and then there are 3 sponsors on there. And I could imagine that there's probably another one thrown on there. But it doesn't look as cluttered as the Brest jersey does. Also, the cut for Kappa looks a little bit nicer. And I know the diagonal stripe probably has not much to say, but it gives it some more interest. So for Adidas, I always had the feeling, yes, it's an Adidas shirt. Yes, this is a classic look, but it's also a little bit unimaginative. Here's a little bit more. The collar is interesting. You have the black underarms, which makes it interesting. We have then this diagonal striping, makes it interesting. I think this is a decent shirt. This is a great shirt. Not really, but I think I would give this 6 stars quite easily. also have to say that the away shirt, that's also kind of white, and then orange and black balance each other out quite nicely. I have to say Crest pops even better. I like this better. Definitely. This is a pretty nice looking jersey. And I also like how the two-line sponsor, each line goes into a different color. This is a really, really smart design. I want to go 8 for that. I really like this. I really, really like this, like I say. And sometimes away jerseys, especially white with some accent color on there, this is something that will always get me. I will always like a whole lot. And then I end up with a whole lot of white jerseys, which is the other thing. In France, just look there, a whole lot of white jerseys. In many, many ways, and some of them are away jerseys, not all of them are. And then the third jersey, again, takes a little bit inspiration from the maritime culture of Lorient. Last season, they had a blue one with the harbor map on there, which I thought was pretty cool. Here, I don't know, this is seemingly also inspired by the harbors of Lorient. It's an interesting pattern. Let's put it that way. But what I like best about it is the blue, white, and orange really go well together. My only gripe with that one is that while I really like the blue, there's another club's color that's not on there, and that is black. That is a little bit missing. Now, I know that if you put black on there, the shirt would not look as nice. So, yeah. Give or take. I think visually it's a very pleasing shirt. I think and for third shirts we don't need to be as strict, because a third shirt should try to take the brand and make something different out of it. Maybe going the blue could be seen as a step too far, but then on the other side I think you get a really pleasing and really nice looking jersey out of this one. I also think that this is even better than a home jersey. I'm not sure if I like it as much as the away jersey back, because despite me loving the colors, I also have to see it as in connection with Lorient itself, and there it doesn't maybe quite jive. So I'm gonna go 7, but it's a strong 7 there. Let's go from the north. We've been way much in the north for this one. Now we go to the south, the next two teams are all south, and Montpellier. Montpellier is one of those teams where the color scheme I always loved. I always loved the blue, and now they have a dark blue with orange. That's something that always jives well. We have seen this template from Nike already with the Red Bull Salzburg jerseys in my Austrian review. I think this one here looks better. I have to say the dark blue with orange is just a very, very strong combination. Again, sponsors are a little bit of an issue. I think Partouche is fine, but doesn't need the sport.fr on the bottom and the phone between the logo. It just seems too crammed in. This would have, I think this could have sat nicer on top of the crest. So by itself, if this was the template with just one sponsor, I probably would go 9. But with the placement of the sponsors, we have to tag it down a little bit. And I am again at the 7. So this is a good looking multi-sponsor jersey. The away jerseys I also like a whole lot. It basically it keeps the orange, but then turns around and it has the navy color and sleeve cuffs. It's also a little bit more colorful, but you know, has the same problems as the other one. I still would give it 7 stars because I really, really liked the overall design. The third shirt is maybe the one where I'm a little bit losing and I couldn't really find a good picture. Black with gold with a template from Nike that I don't like. Even the crest doesn't look right, to be honest. So for me, without a context, and you know, if there's some context added by you guys, please drop a line below. But without a context, I cannot give this a high grade. And then also the swoosh is completely misplaced on there. So yeah, for me, this is a 4-star. Sorry, but I know black and gold is popular, but this, A, it is not Montpellier to me, and B, it is badly done, especially with the white swoosh. And so we are at the last team of this season, which is Nice. A team that grabbed the coach from Lille and wants to do a whole lot of things, has high ambitions Red and black. When I saw this shirt, I'm thinking Milan 12-13 in many ways. Maybe the black sleeves, thin striping. It is very much... This is how I would imagine a Milan jersey if Macron were the suppliers, which is actually something I would wish for. Again, the picture here makes it look probably much, much better because I assume there are a whole lot more sponsors on there. I know the French league. There's at least one here up on the shoulders. But other than that, there is just something about this jersey that I like a whole lot. Last season, this jersey was a little bit of a train wreck. This one hits me exactly on the right spots again and, you know, reminds me of a good, of an interesting Milan shirt in a way. The white collar is nicely balanced out by the white sleeve cuffs, and then we have kind of the red and black. Again, I'm gonna go 8 stars with, depending, because I don't know all the sponsors now. Sponsors might knock this down a whole lot, but then again, black and gold, I get it. Black is at least the club's color, and you want to have an away shirt. Yes, it's fine. I'm getting a little bit too tired of black and gold shirts, to be honest. There are a few that are really nice, and we'll talk about some really nice ones already last season, this season. I'm just a little bit tired of this one. I think this is the third shirt. I've now skipped the home shirt. But yeah, let's give the third shirt. I want to give it a 6. And the away shirt is the same thing in white. So sorry for switching it around. Here, I think even the crest looks weird because the eagle is also white. So it's only the shield remains. This looked better on the third shirt. It's a nice cut overall, but nah, it doesn't do much for me. I honestly have to say, I would go even as far as say that this is, yeah. Now let's say 5 because, you know, it's not too cluttered. And then the third shirt is this, I mean, it has at least the club's colors, but again, do you see the eagle? No, not really. Well, let's see only the shield. And I'm not sure how red is this red. It's more of an orangey red, so it's also, yeah, I expect more from Macron too, to be honest. So I would also say, I want to give it a 6, as I did for the third shirt. It's, for once, I didn't like the white shirt because I think white and gold just don't go well together. So there you have it. First 5 teams are in the books. I know it's already a long video, but there were a whole lot of jerseys in there. I want to know, which jerseys did you like in here? Do you agree with my ratings, or would you have graded them differently? Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more, and I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you actually might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and click that little bell, so in order to stay updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. With that, have a good day.